It seems like everyone is in a race to grow their follower count. And as someone who runs social media and influencer marketing for two ed tech brands, I will never knock the influence that social media plays in today's society. It's one of the main reasons why I love doing what I do for a living. However, I have to be realistic and I want to make sure I share with you the importance of email marketing. So if you click this video, you've probably already started an email list, or maybe you're not quite sure if it's worth the time, which is your investment, to do something like this. And let me just go ahead and say again, as much as I love social media, when you are building your brand only on social media, you're building on borrowed land. You don't own anything. So you are at the mercy of all of those social media platforms. You do not have access to their emails. You don't have access to any of that kind of particular data, which can then be a crutch whenever you're at the mercy of the algorithm games that they play. Because let's say you took a couple of days off or the content you posted isn't performing as well. What would happen if all of a sudden that social media platform accidentally deactivated your account because of a random flag and you could no longer contact your followers through that app? How are you going to reach out to them? It's kind of scary when you think about it that way, right? So again, as much as I love social media influencer marketing, I do believe that you just gotta start growing your email list and you're gonna learn along the way, but everybody has to start somewhere. So let's get you started today. Hi, I'm Amber and I lead social media influencer marketing for two ed tech brands. I was a former teacher, TPT seller, that now also coaches and consults teacher business owners through Teacher Marketing Academy. We already closed the doors to Teacher Marketing Academy's first launch and prior to that, a 2-month coaching program, and I will reopen the doors soon. But until then, I am so glad that you are a part of this YouTube fam watching and learning, because I love nothing more than helping you grow and scale your business. So in this video, I'm going to share all about ways to grow your email list. And if you're not sure where to start, I'm gonna link a video down below all about how to start an email list for TPT sellers. Consider this video part 2. However, you can still watch this one and then go back to that one if you prefer. I'm gonna have it in an email marketing playlist. Okay, let's get started. The first way to grow your email list is in the form of creating new content. Now, why? Because you have to give them a reason to give you their email address. If you simply just say, "Hey, join my email list," well, that kind of sounds a little selfish, and what's in it for them? So I'm gonna share with you a few different ways that you can create new content to get that coveted email address and have direct access to their inbox. The first one is a checklist. Do you have any documented processes, or are you an expert in certain areas of teaching that could be kind of created in the form of a checklist that the teacher needs to follow? So what if it's a checklist for wrapping up the end of the year, or a checklist for parent communication must-dos? Think of anything you've already created, scour your Instagram, scour your blog posts, and think to yourself, how can I create an additional quick piece of content in the form of a checklist? I did this with my spring cleaning checklist in the spring, where I thought of different ways teachers could tidy up their business in different areas like social media, their blog, their email, their inbox, and it didn't take me that long, but I pre-thought out ideas for teachers, and in exchange of receiving these checklists, they gave me their email address. And again, this is more of a reciprocal partnership, right? Like, you give me something, I give you something. So you wanna make sure that, again, you're not being super selfish. The second type of new content that you could create is any type of printable. Have you ever created specific content, but it wasn't quite meaty enough for Teachers Pay Teachers, or let's say it's maybe worth 50 cents or a dollar? Well, could you then in turn bring that to your email list as something that they can receive for free, again, in exchange for the email address? This is a way to make the most out of different resources that you've hodgepodged throughout the year, but they're not quite ready for TPT, or you don't plan on making it a part of a suite of products. So that's another idea for you as well. And the third is something I want to spend a little time on. Hang with me, okay? But it's a resource library. I really don't like resource libraries. I think they're only useful if you have a particular strategy in place. So let me go ahead and kind of like reframe my mindset there. So Amber, why do you think resource libraries aren't that great? Well, I think if you are only creating a dump of resources that they can just sign up, they get that code, and then they have access to everything that you've thrown in there for so long, There's no strategy behind it. And they can quickly unsubscribe. And after they get everything that they want, they resubscribe. And then they get what they want maybe a couple of months later. But there's no advocacy for them wanting to open your emails every week. Because you've kind of shown all of your, like, your cards, and they don't need anything else from you. So when you try to hard sell, or when you try to show, you know, things that you've created on your blog or a new YouTube video, it's not really relevant to them as much, because they're only gonna download the freebies, right? And of course you're gonna have people that are like that, but you wanna make sure that you also couple it with value. If you want to get super technical, another reason why I'm not a huge fan of resource libraries is because I see those five freebies as five different funnels, five different email funnels that I could create to send teachers down a particular path to a paid product that I sell. That's a super technical that teachers in Teacher Marketing Academy and I worked through for quite a few weeks to make sure that they truly understood it. So I'm not gonna put that in this YouTube video because it'll feel a little overwhelming, but just know there are a lot of different ways that you can make sure what works best for you also helps put more dollars in your wallet. The next piece of free content that I want to share is bonus content. And I want to be super frank. You're going to hear me say certain words, bonus content, this like gated content. And just know that everybody in the marketing world says something different. It's all jargon. Other marketers may call things different. It's just like an education. So I kind of want to just make sure we kind of like, you know, level set that for a second. But bonus content. And a way that you can think about bonus content is content that is additional to something that you already have. And one of my suggestions here is, if you have a paid resource, maybe it's a bigger ticket item like a bundle, can you create a free product? And it, like, again, it can be something super, super simple, like a checklist, a printable, anything like that. But you can also promote your paid resource in that download, but you gate people, like you kind of like reel them in with this free resource as opposed to this $20 product, because this is more value for them to use right now. And then if they really like this, and then maybe they see your content, they might decide, ooh, I really want this too. That's another thing to keep in mind when it comes to free content. You want to make sure that, again, let's recap. When you're creating new content, you want to provide value to the teacher so then they feel comfortable giving you access to their inbox, so then you can beat the algorithm and just kind of like access them whenever you can. And that can be in the form of new content like checklists, printables, a resource library done very strategically if that's what you want, and bonus content. So let's go ahead and talk about the next set. I'm gonna share four more strategies to grow your email list in addition to new content, so make sure you stay until the very end. The next one is actually the oldest trick in the book, and you've probably fallen for it quite a few times, and it's quizzes. Have you ever taken a quiz where it's, what type of blank are you? If you were a breakfast food or a character in a book, which one would you be? And you take the quiz and then you get to the end, and the only way to actually get your results is to insert your email address. This is one of the quick and easiest ways. If the quiz is really tailored to your niche enough, then you're going to get tons of email addresses out of sheer curiosity of them wanting to know their answer. Now, there's a lot of strategy involved in the quiz, but at the highest level, you actually want each of your results to tie into a different product that you sell. So then, regardless of whatever they pick, it's still a way for you to get a potential lead where they'll purchase something. So if you sell different types of products, maybe it's costume organization, costume decor, so it's like, what's your main, or even what's your main teaching style? And each one could lead towards like centers, like, oh, you're the center king, queen, you're the independent study guru, and then you may have like different products that leads to something like that. So you can get super creative. Now, again, I'm sharing all of these ideas, but I do want to level set for a second. Do you notice high level set all the time? So I want to make sure that although I'm sharing all of these ideas that you can use to grow your email list, you don't have to do every single one. And it's really important as a business owner to know what you have time to do, and more importantly, what you don't have time to do, and pick the things that's going to move your business forward faster and quicker without getting lost in the hustle and bustle, okay? So I want to make sure that you understand I'm sharing all of these ideas Think about which one's most relevant for your business or which one you feel, yes, Amber, I can tackle that one right now and go for it, okay? So I wanna make sure before you hear all these things, you're like, she just gave me so many ideas. Focus. I had to do the same for myself as well. Okay, the next way that you can grow your email list is one that I worked on with the edtech companies I work on when we were a small startup, and it's events. And particularly, I'm gonna talk about hosting a webinar. I've actually seen a lot of teacherpreneurs do this more lately. So instead of having a live Facebook training, Instagram live training, YouTube video, which is what I'm doing, there are opportunities to maybe create a presentation deck and say, I'm hosting this live training. Maybe you're gonna throw two or three different time slots for people to join. They can insert their email address to watch live or receive the recording. I always say that because I wanna make sure people feel that even though if the time doesn't work for them, they can still watch it at their own time. And honestly, sometimes they really don't, let's be real, but I still get their email address to reach out to them later. You're giving them exclusive access that they can't find anywhere else in any of your other channels. It's gonna be directly targeted towards a specific need, and there's a call to action at the end. So you wanna make sure always, always, always you're providing value, but then at the end, you do have your pitch, so to speak, of what maybe you wanna pitch. So if it's about organizing your classroom, you may have an organizational system that you sell on TPT that you wanna give them access to buy. And maybe anybody who purchases within the next 24 hours and leaves a review with something, you may also send them a freebie. I don't know, that's a little extra. I'm kinda just now thinking glitter elbow macaroni, but you get my point. So create value in the deck, sell at the end, and that way they feel, again, you have enough deposits to make a withdrawal. So that's the second one, is in the form of hosting a webinar. Also, if you have like an online conference, those are great ways. If it's free, if it's paid, whichever, that's an easy way also. Well, it's not easy, it actually takes a ton of work, but I don't wanna spend a lot of time on that because I feel like the webinar is most applicable to solopreneurs. The next way to grow your email list is one you're probably familiar with, but I'm gonna give it a little twist, and it's using social media. I'm sure that you have promoted your email list if you already have one on social media, but how often do you actually do it? Did you do it once and then kind of forgot about it, or you felt like, oh, I did it at the beginning of July and I can't do it at the end of July because then they're gonna get annoyed with me? They forget, and half of them probably haven't watched it anyways. That's just the way the algorithm works, right? Not everybody's watching your content all of the time, so you do need to recycle that messaging so then new people or people that may not have seen your content in the beginning also see it again. So there's different ways to promote on social media, and the first is you could run a social contest. Maybe you wanna do a contest that you're specifically promoting on social media, and the only way to enter is to provide your email their email address. This is gonna be a great way to, again, give them something value, a chance to win, but at the same time, you get access to their email address. A second one is you wanna make sure that it's in your Instagram bio or, you know, Twitter bio, whatever you use, so then they actually know that it's available for you. I use Kajabi for my, I used to use Linktree for the edtech companies. I use Linktree, but now I use Kajabi because, as you know, I use Kajabi to run my courses, my email marketing, everything, and I just feel like it's a great done for you type of product. So I encourage you to go to my Instagram, check out the, click the link, check out how I have the email list subscribed in there. It's really cool, but of course other platforms also have ways that you can promote as well. I just wanted to give you that option. The second one is you wanna make sure, like, on your YouTube description as well, talk about it, don't be afraid. Again, if I were to talk about this whole video and I was like, don't forget to subscribe to my email list, don't forget to subscribe to my email list, that would be so annoying and you would get really ticked with me, right? But if I just remember to say, oh, and if you're not a part of my email list, I'm leaving it down below, and I send emails every week where I give marketing tips only found in that newsletter, so you wanna make sure that you're a part of the email fam so you can get stuff you can't get anywhere else. Notice how I gave you value, but it was super quick, and guess what? Then I can, boom, move on to the next thing. Maybe it'll pique some of y'all's interest, maybe it won't, but I'm gonna say it again, maybe in the next video, or if you check my description in the next video, maybe if I don't say it, it'll still be there, so I stay top of mind for you. So, moral of the story, when you promote on social media, be conscious of how often you're sharing it, because more than likely you're not talking about it too much, and or you're not talking about it enough, and or you can just do it really quickly to where it feels like an afterthought and it's not like a, oh, I'm selling them this, and you know, you kind of get what I mean. Okay, so the next way that you can promote on social media, I guess technically is not social media, but you can promote it on your website. So you can add a pop-up form, that way people can, when they're reading the content that you're creating on your website, they're finding value in it. I embed the forms directly in certain blog posts when I feel like it's relevant. I also have a pop-up form. Here's a tip though. I noticed some people create a pop-up form literally the second people land on your page. And I need you to kind of like hold your horses for a second, because a lot of those teachers don't even know who you are. And it's almost like, we say this in marketing, and it's like, you're kind of going in for the kiss, but like you haven't started to date them yet, okay? So you wanna make sure that like they're on your page for a little bit and you kind of show your authority before you ask for their email address. Because if they land on your email address and then all of a sudden you're asking them for something, it kind of gives off like a used car salesman vibe. I don't know, that's just me. If you are like, I'm gonna keep it, well, I can tell you what I think, but you're gonna make the best decision for your business. There are so many more ideas, but the last one for this video that I'm going to share on how to grow your email list is to use Pinterest. As you know, I've talked about it on my Instagram, I've talked about it on my website. I love using Pinterest marketing for my business because I feel because it is a search engine and not a social media platform, it really levels the playing field for people who don't have a huge amount of following. So I actually create unique fresh pins, specifically promoting my email list as a way to as a newsletter, as a way to provide value for my audience. And those pins do pretty well. So I'll link some examples of them so you can see what they look like. And I get unique people directly from Pinterest to join my email list, which then gets funneled to all of my other channels. So you want to make sure, again, just because your main channel may be this one social media platform, don't think that you can't leverage the other platforms to also increase awareness, because that's how you're going to then increase your reach and thus increase your revenue. That's it for this video, how to grow an email list for TPT sellers. If you liked this type of content, please do me a favor and take a few moments to give it a like. Leave a comment below, let me know which ones you're already implementing to growing your email list and which ones you wanna try. Also, if you have any questions along the way, I am definitely going to answer the comments. It feels so good to get back into YouTube, and I want nothing more than to connect with y'all. So a simple like lets me know like, hey, I'm here, I'm listening. Don't ghost us again. Keep making content. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of your business. Share ideas. I want nothing more than to see you grow and succeed. And I'm gonna finish drinking my energy drink, but thanks again, and I will see you in my next video.